Millions of Americans struggling with obesity now have access to a newly approved weight loss drug. It's called ZEPBOUND, and it's an injectable medication with the same ingredient as the diabetes drug Mounjaro, Ozempic, all of those which have been shown to curb hunger cravings and help shed some pounds. And joining us now to talk about it and how it works is Dr. Shafu. Thank you so much for being here.
Good to be here, Maria.
Let's talk about the ZEPBOUND. Is it a semi-glutide in the same class as those other?
Exactly. And basically, the mechanism that it works is it actually acts like a couple of our hormones to reduce our craving, to allow for weight loss and also for insulin management. So essentially, it works by acting on certain receptors in the brain called GLP-1 and GIP, and those are specific areas in the brain that are responsible for our diet, for our appetite, and and also the motility of our GI tract, and also insulin production. So if you can really attack those issues, then you can have a significant impact upon weight. And they were formed obviously for type 2 diabetes.
I mean, initially. It seems to work, how effective is it really? Do we know?
Yeah, we do. Actually, there was a really good, we've talked about this before, randomized controlled clinical trial over 72 weeks. And these were people that were getting ZEPBOUND. And what they found, Maria, was that at the end of that study period, that patients that were obese lost about 21% of their total body weight, which is significant. However, if you take that same group in a second study and they made changes in their diet, in their exercise or activity level, they found that there was up to a 25% reduction in total body weight. So you need that combination, really.
We've got to change our habits.
Absolutely, yes.
How is it different from Ozempic or Mounjaro, of those?
So it works on the two areas of the brain. Ozempic primarily works on what's called the GLP-1, whereas the ZEPBOUND works on both the GLP-1 receptors and also the GIP. So both, those two centers are both involved in your appetite, which is a big factor.
So once you lessen your appetite and slow down your GI, you're just not eating a lot.
Not eating as much, exactly.
What are the potential side effects? Right, usually stomach issues.
Exactly. It's all pretty much GI symptoms. So nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, constipation is possible. Mm-hmm. And then also, these are drugs that you have to be careful because if you have an underlying GI motility problem, they're probably not such a great choice to utilize.
So it's not good for everybody.
Correct.
Who should not take it?
Right, so that would be one group. There is evidence that it can be associated with pancreatitis, can be associated with cholecystitis or gallbladder disease, or thyroid cancer. So if you have a family history of what we call MEN or multiple endocrine neoplasia, those are people that should stay away from utilizing those drugs. But that's obviously not the majority of people.
So semaglutides, in general, I know that they cost for some people $700 to $1,000 a month.
Yes.
So how long are you taking this for?
Indefinitely.
That's frightening.
Because if you think of, it's like a patient said, they're taking an antihypertensive agent, right? Well, they're not going to suddenly stop that. It's a lifetime problem. The same with diabetics. And we think, unfortunately, obesity is a lifetime type illness that people struggle through throughout their lifetime. So it's probably not going to be a point at which you stop it. But like you were saying earlier on, the most important thing is that these should probably at some point be covered by insurance, because what are the health care costs associated with not managing our obesity? We know that obviously diabetes is a much higher risk in people that are overweight, atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease, heart attacks, strokes, and think of the impact, not just for one's health, but the health care dollar impact of treating diseases after they've already presented seriously versus as a preventative treatment.
Yeah, obesity is a crisis in our country.
It is.
Do you think we'll be seeing more of these drugs? This attacks not just the GLP-1 and the it does both.
It does
so,
both.
Are we going to see more?
So I'm sure this is just the tip of the iceberg, right? So there's more and more research being done. And, while 20% or 25% is a significant number, obviously if you're morbidly obese, that can get you started, but you still need to change your lifestyle, change your activity level, you know, getting to see a dietitian who can really change what are the food groups that you eat. You know, you want more fruits, you want more vegetables, you want more fiber. You know, if you're going to take meat, you want a meat that's less fat, more fish-like products. So it's really, you know, educating ourselves. You know, as we've said so many times before on the show, it's becoming a really good advocate for yourself.
So it can jumpstart the weight loss, but yes. You definitely have to change your habits.
Totally.
All right. Yeah. Dr. Richard Chafu, thank you so much for joining us in studio and kind of breaking it all down for us. We appreciate it.
Of course.